Hello, I'm Dr. Manor Haas. I'm a certified endodontist from Toronto, Canada. In this segment, I would like to review the management of large or ovoid canals, canals with no apical constrictions, post-space preparations, and retreatment of GuttaCore. First, I'll speak about obturation of ovoid canals. As shown in the video, in ovoid or large canals, I personally like to place a single master gutta-percha point corresponding to your master file at one side of the canal, and in turn leaving space for the GuttaCore that will be inserted alongside of it. To improve visibility and reduce interference with the warm GuttaCore that will be inserted, I suggest cutting the cold gutta-percha at or below the occlusal table. This is the same as when I recommended doing with the paper points meant to block out adjacent canals. This is optional, but in large canals, and as you may see in this clip, I like to downpack the warm GuttaCore gutta-percha around the cold gutta-percha in order to provide an even better obturation. Second, I'll speak about canals with no apical constriction. These include, but are not limited, to cases with apical pathology or canals you know have been instrumented large beyond the apex. In such cases, I recommended that you obturate at least 1 millimeter short of your working length. And remember to use very little sealer in these canals. This will help reduce extrusion of sealer and or gutta-percha. This case of mine, of the maxillary central with an apical lesion, demonstrates how using too much sealer and or not filling short of the working length could result in unintentional extrusion. Third, I'll speak about post-preparation. Preparing a post-space in canals obturated with GuttaCore is quite easy. Simply wait maybe about 30 seconds or so to allow the GuttaCore to set, and then you may use nearly any drill you wish to make your post-space. This could be done the same way as you would with plain gutta-percha obturations. I found that you don't necessarily need special post-based drills for GuttaCore. I can't say the same with other carrier-based obturations, however. Now I'll speak about retreatment. In the unlikely event you need to remove your GuttaCore, I recommend using a Hetstrom file for engaging and removing the GuttaCore. As seen in this video, turn a Hetstrom file in a clockwise direction to engage into the GuttaCore and pull the file coronally. This is very easy to perform, especially before the GuttaCore has fully set. If or once the sealer is fully set, you may retreat the GuttaCore the same way you would any other gutta-percha based obturations. Now I'd like to discuss accessibility into difficult to reach sites. Now, most root canal treatments are performed on posterior teeth, which are often more challenging to reach because of the opposing arch or the patient's limited opening. With that in mind, I would like to mention that from a practical and clinical perspective, it's not just about getting warm 3D obturation of the root canal system, but it's just as important to evaluate if your warm obturation system can enable you to obturate with ease in difficult to access areas. In this video, you can see how accessibility into posterior teeth is amongst various obturation systems on the market. As you can see in the clinical demonstration, only the GuttaCore obturators can make warm 3D obturation so easy in difficult to reach sites. The ability to break off the GuttaCore handle and turn the obturator into a shorter and easily maneuverable gutta-percha separates this from other warm obturation systems on the market. Many obturation systems may enable you to obturate with warm gutta-percha, but please ask yourself if they can be used easily, predictably, comfortably in more difficult to reach sites. So to recap, I've shown how you can obturate large ovoid canals, how to manage canals with no apical constriction, how to easily prepare post spaces and retreat canals obturated with GuttaCore. Finally, I demonstrated how GuttaCore stands out and above other warm obturations by enabling you to obturate so easily in difficult to reach sites. I hope you found this useful. Good luck, and thank you for your time.